Hello everyone, my name is Raylazor and welcome back to Ring of Fates. Today we're heading off to Kilanda, or Io Kilanda, but before we do that, I have to mention that we have a lot more money, and that's because I sold off our weapons, body, armor, and all that stuff. And I've cleared out all our scrolls from the old stuff that we don't need, so we're left with pretty much only the princess insignia, since we haven't crafted that yet. But otherwise, I think we're pretty much ready to go. Now, Kalanda's a little bit hard here and there, so I recommend grabbing a few potions, because it can turn poorly very quickly. At any rate, let's head on through and get moving. So before we even move on from the stage, you can actually turn back to see a bunch of bees behind you. And further behind that is a barrel full of gil, which we'll be able to get at in a bit. First, let's take care of these bees. They're very annoying when they poison you, so act accordingly. Play at ranged if you can. If you're not a ranged class, then make sure you have a few clear magicites on hand just in case. So we're gonna get a pretty early level up. That's good. And if I didn't break the barrel back here, I did, but you can get at 800 pieces of gil right away. So if you're a little low on crafting money, you can head in here, dip in, and grab a little bit of gil before heading back to town. And of course, you can also farm for money here if you want to. Not exactly the most efficient way, but listen, do what you need to. 800's not too bad, but I find it a little monotonous going in and out from that portal and just wasting a bunch of time, so we're just gonna move ahead from here on. And what I want to do is just clear out this area of all their darn bees, but generally this area is relatively plain, so we won't have to worry too much about it. The big worry is that Kilanda Io has a mix of plant life, fire life, and ice life, and pretty much everything else. This is where you're gonna see pretty much all the enemies you've seen throughout the game just show up here and there. You got multiple skins for each of the moves that's going on, so plenty of stuff to do in Kilanda here. This video might be a little bit longer than the other ones. Should still sit around 1 hour though, so hopefully it doesn't get too long and boring, but we're gonna have to see how that goes. Anyways, that's pretty much it for this area. Let's clear out this barrel. Garnet, iron. Not stuff we really need, but always good to have some. Let's move on ahead here, and this area is already very confusing. So this is one of the two Loki paths that are hanging around Kilanda Isle for this map right here. From what I understand, there's no real way for any of the classes to move ahead without like messing with them. I'm not really sure how to say that, so a lot of Kilanda Io might be like advanced through improperly. I'm still going to try to kill all the enemies on the map to stay ahead in levels, but I might be going at it a different way from what you might normally see. So you'll notice I'm going up here first in order to take care of these moves and break the sparrow here. Not much we really need in it, but this area is relatively far out and I don't think it's really necessary to completing this little map here, but always good to take care of some lava moves. So that's our first set of moves that we've seen hanging around here. Gonna be able to see more in a bit. We have a flan goop here, so I'm just gonna do a quick charge attack or get hit. Sure, let's try this again. There we go. And it will immediately die thanks to our superior firepower. I'm not actually sure what our firepower is going on right now. You'll notice this video is coming out about a week late or something. It's because of a few things. So what I want to do is, what do we have here? We got Dragoon Lore, alright. So nothing much, alright. So we should be doing what we're usually doing. That's good. But sorry this video has come out so late. Besides dealing with exams, the city I'm in, Calgary, recently had a few power outages. Generally, that's not very good for recording, especially 1 hour long ones, because you don't get your recording, everything breaks on you, you lose your save and your progress, so I've had a good few days out of it. My weekend was spent going to a cool old convention, literally cool because, you know, it's cold and it's November, but all in all, things will hopefully heat back up here. Did you see that joke here? We're gonna get to the warm side of Kilanda, basically. Let's step on the switch here and lower this ladder. Is this what a ladder is called? I get my ladders and staircases and elevators mixed up, so that's weird. Anyways, we're gonna deal with a lot of chimeras here, and that is a chimera. Basically a lion with like a kid sticking out of it or something as bait. Generally, these things are used on like certain points in the map to tell you that you're supposed to be there. They're pretty strong, they have a bulky amount of health. You could technically call them a mini boss if you wanted to. But besides denoting that you're moving in the proper direction. They also drop some pretty good things, so one of the things that comes to mind would be Chimera Blood, which is used for most high-level crafting things and whatnot. And I think it's necessary to get one of the really high-leveled equipment, so always spend your time to kill a few of them if you do have the time. They're always helpful. Anyways, let's check on this right side here. And this is where you're supposed to go, I guess? Let's just take care of these bees first. Alright, get a little bit too close with them. There we are, okay. So I can only assume right now you're supposed to actually jump on this loti pad because the platform is already moving. This is a little bit strange for a platform. They could have easily used a piece of rock, but that just makes things weird. And of course, there's nothing to really hit the switch, so we're gonna have to balance it out in the center and then just jump across. So it's possible for other classes, but the usage of loti pads just make things a little confusing. Anyways, let's put the key in and get on forward. Get on forward, is that a saying? I don't know. This area, also just as large and expansive, contains a lot of vertical height, and it's a little bit annoying to deal with because you have stuff on different levels and floors and they merge together in a very strange way, so you're busy hopping back and forth. This might be a little bit annoying for any classes that aren't Silkies here, but otherwise, it's not actually necessary. You can skip pretty easily by just heading off to the bottom right of the entrance immediately. And that way you won't have to deal with all of these shenanigans here. There's nothing too important here, but I do want to get as many scrolls for Kilanda as I can, because there's a few item sets lying around here, and things are a little strange with the stuff you'll be getting from Kilanda, and that'll show up in the future. But for now, let's just deal with a bunch of bats. Yeah, these things are annoying. There we go. And one more. There we are. Great. Now, there should be up here. Yep, there we go. All right. What's in here? That's a scroll. All right, we're going to get an anti-code helmet. So, another frost-based item. They're starting to get a little confusing. Kind of hard to keep track of them, but you have, like, the icy garb. You have the blue clothes, and then now you have this anti-frost, which is either a red helmet or a blue helmet. Anyways, it's all just a big old mess, and here you'll notice that you actually do need to step on the fire for the most part. Eventually, you will have to, so if you're trying to avoid it, just don't bother. It's a little too hard to do that. You don't lose too much health either, and I think I'm immune to it right now? I'm not taking any damage for some reason. I do have a plus one on fire, so this is actually a pretty sweet deal for me here. Great, let's hopefully keep this up here, and it looks like we have a flan here, so I don't even know how you managed to get an attack up here so quickly. Jeez, flan. Alright, there we go. Let's take care of you. Alright, it only had 2 extra points of health, and we are good. Got a piece of silver here, and I guess this thing's sticking out from the middle of nowhere? Why not? Got ourselves a pet eye amethyst. That's pretty good. Generally a gemstone I do want. And let's deal with some more moves. As you can tell, this area is very confusing for me. Even running through it for a few times makes it difficult. I don't really know how I want to progress through these levels, so I often just hop around doing nothing, looking around, just find things to kill here and there, and we'll probably be able to cover the map in time. Got a few magic sites in here, I believe. Yeah. And some iron shards and garnet. Once again, don't really need them, but always nice to have. Also, I should mention that I did clear out a few of the materials we had, and that primarily consists of copper and iron shards and stuff like that that we won't really need. Refining it takes a lot of time since you can't do it in bulk, so often I just choose to buy it or just collect it from the game. Anyways, here we go. Our level 26 provides us with straight arrow, and that will now allow us to pierce through enemies, and generally makes our bow a little bit more effective and more dynamic to use. Always great, but it doesn't play as big as a key factor as you may think. Of course, in mobbing, this is obviously very helpful. Having 3 arrows and having them pierce through is always good. So let's go here and try to deal with this chimera here. Chimera. Doesn't matter. Just take care of you. There we go. Stomp on your head a little bit. Generally, not too difficult to deal with. It can blind you, though, and those two dark spell balls are kind of annoying as well, so stuff to keep in mind. Okay, that thing is, right. I am surprised I didn't get hit by that second one, but I think we're done here. We also got thunderous garbs here now going on. Is that from the last area? I think that might have been from the last area, so hopefully we won't have to worry about it. Now, I haven't been reading these signs, but the icy floor is very cold, so you'll be careful, Kupo. You'll freeze solid if you step on them. Basically, the Kilanda consists of very hot areas, very cold areas, and just areas in between. And that's how they managed to combine annoying ice bombs with less annoying fire bombs with a little more annoying lightning bombs. They're just all mashed together here. Generally not a fan of bombs, which is why I can't say I'm the most fond of Kilanda, but there is a good reason to stay and stick around through these places, so we'll be able to show that in the near future, not too far from here. In the meantime, we still have quite a few enemies to take care of. And in the meantime, I should mention, we've gotten quite a few level ups so far, so this is doing pretty good here. I'm a little bit afraid of freezing over, especially near enemies. Oftentimes, they'll start spellcasting and doing damage to you. And of course, being a Selkie, we have a negative 1 to Frost, so I don't know where we got that from. That might just be a thing that Selkies naturally have, and I am not a fan. Anyways, I think we'll worry about the top part of this ice in a bit. Instead, I think I want to move around first before going up through, so this area might be a little bit weird on how I take it on, but otherwise not too much to worry about, hopefully. Alright, let's take care of this bat as well. Great. Now, by moving off to this far end point where there's all a bunch of, like, hot rocks or something, we're going to be able to get out of scroll a silver light armor, and I think that gets us the silver corselet, which I think we realized in the last episode, so I'm not sure why we got it early, but we did, and I don't believe there is a helmet to go with it, which is very strange. I'm not really sure how some of the equipment sets work in here, and a lot of the ones in Kilanda, including the silver corselet, are sort of broken, and it's a pain. I won't be able to show all the equipment choices and the entirety of all sets because things are sort of blended together strangely. There may be a glitch or two here and there. Very confusing in general. Anyways, let's just forget about all that nonsense, and now we will deal with another ice bomb. I think I want to use my tribal ability for this guy, since we got a pretty nice range here, and we're doing pretty good damage, as you can see. 300 and 500, that's pretty solid. Alright, we're gonna take this guy down here, and what's in the barrel? More money. I will gladly appreciate that. I'm thinking we're sitting at like 11,000 right now. Yeah, that's pretty good. Pretty close call here, so we're gonna be doing just fine economic-wise. Alright. What is up here? Ice! Great, there's a chest in the middle of nowhere. I have a feeling that there's gonna be a bunch of enemies that spawn from that direction, so gotta be really cautious here on the ice. Definitely annoying if we accidentally deal with an ice bomb while we're frozen. It'll probably spell game over for us, so let's definitely approach this with a little bit of caution here. The moves aren't too much of a danger since they don't cast spells, but you just never want to deal with enemies here. I'll often hop around on ice in order to not get frozen, but even then, that's not the most effective thing out there. Alright. I think I'm just gonna tribal ability you, since you're just standing there, and I don't feel like going on that ice. Alright, we got a mover and some yellow fey dust. Okay, cool, nothing new. And we're gonna deal with another move here. Alright, so far so good, I suppose. Not too much to worry about. And looks like a charge attack is pretty effective on these guys, so I might be using this a little bit more often. And by often, I mean I'm gonna just run away first, because this guy, not a fan of you. Yeah, you just hang on the other side. Yeah, you keep doing what you're doing there. Great. Alright, let's heal up our SP while we're at it. There we are. And we'll switch to using Cure Magicite, since that pocket has been maxed out this entire time. Climb over here, and we're gonna check the left side first. Anything here? No? Alright. Well, anyways, by going to the right side, we will be able to find our first little piece of evidence to advancing from this area. And that's a chimera followed by a balloon. And now I've been knocked down. As you can tell, it's going to be a key. We're just gonna hop up here right now because I don't feel like crawling all the way back, but apparently I shot the balloon while I was at it. So there you go. Spoiler warning, you have to shoot the balloons. Anyways, let's take care of this chimera while we're at it then. Might as well. Hopefully we'll get something good to craft with from these guys. Always a fun thing to kill. In the meantime though, I'm just gonna wander away from you guys. A little dangerous to deal with chimeras. Just a little bit. And... oh, it's not dead yet. Curses, we got blinded. Alright, well, we took care of it. And we're going to get a feline spirit. So that is something that comes from a chimera as well, I believe. And an angel's weapon, something that we probably won't be crafting. Anyways, there is something attached to the balloons, Kupo. How about knocking down those windbags, Kupo? I don't know what you're talking about, Mr. Mugo. I see nothing. Alright. Well, let's take care of these things, and I think we only have a few more enemies to kill before we can move on, so let's just carry the key with us and see what we have. Alright, we got a moo. We got two. And we have two moos. Cool. Oh, and an ice bomb. And three moos. Great. We forgot about that chest. Okay, so how do I want to do this? It's generally not very easy to shoot upwards with a tribal ability, and this guy... oh, I am not fond of you. Right, let's just hang down here. I'd rather take my time on this guy instead of be a little too hasty, so... let's take care of this move first. Please don't drop down here. Yeah, just stay up there, please. I insist. Oh my gosh, okay. I don't even know what that means, but... mm-mm. You're a danger. A danger that is eliminated. Haha, alright. What's in the box? We got an angel's weapon. Alright, another one that's not exactly the best since we aren't going to be crafting these, presuming I'm able to get the other weapon. So we'll probably make at least one just so I can show off the item description, but you probably won't be seeing it in action. So let's just work on you. Up here, heal, get frozen probably. There we go. And moo. Moo, where are you? And there we go. Oh, it's not dead yet. There's two. Okay, well, this is where a piercing ability comes in then. There we are. Alright, well, we're just gonna be freezing here a lot. And as you can see, it happens so often, which makes it pretty viable to just hop around like we stubbed our toe. Alright, let's get this key in here. And we'll just take care of that moo while it's busy being sealed in. There we go. Got a nice meaty shot on him. And we finally took it out. There we go. Alright, nothing for us to pick up here, so let's move on. Alright. Okay, so I do have a plan for going at it for this area. And what you can do right now is go for that fire pillar right there. Yeah. And then hop right off to the left side to deal with the lightning pillar next. Or you can hop to the right side to deal with the blizzard pillar. This makes no sense just yet, but we basically have to fill three pillars to break the barriers. Not sure what to call them. Tables? Magicite tables? That's kind of lame, but... here, in the meantime, let's focus on getting rid of one of these barriers first. And I think we're going to be doing this fire one as suggested. And what this will do is... unlock one of three barriers. Cool. Now, I think I'm going to go for the blizzard one next. So we're going to be moving to the right side first. It's completely fine to move to the left side first, but I do have a plan of movement before we worry about this and that, so let's just make sure that we clear out all the enemies that are sitting on these, like, fire pillars, fire ground things. I'm getting my words mixed up. Basically, let's take care of these enemies that are sitting on the islands here. And you'll notice there's giant chunks of ice in the background. You can actually break that, and this will, well, if we aren't gonna... oh, I hate auto-aim in this game. Okay, let's just charge our attack then. You'll see these ice pillars can be broken, and they contain enemies, and they usually block your pathway. They also give you ways of moving a little bit faster throughout the map, so we're going to go over there in a second, but I want to make sure that we've cleared out all the enemies that are hanging around here first. And it's starting to look like we have, so we won't have to worry about too much. A bunch of lava there, so... we're just gonna avoid all that. No fun sinking in that stuff, so let's go over here then. And here we're noticing three chests. And by breaking them, we get a bunch of mana sites, a scroll, and two attack boosts. These aren't the only set of permanent upgrades in this area, however, so we're going to be able to deal with a few more up ahead, so don't assume that you're all fine and dandy now that you've taken care of them. There's more. And that's what makes Kilanda probably one of the best places to go to improve your attack power. So each run through of Kilanda yields you up to 4 attack boosts, which is pretty impressive considering you rarely find them in the Mog Mart, so it's definitely viable to just come here and grind out all the attack boosts you want, and then wear whatever equipment you want. Just make yourself look nice and dainty, whatever equipment you could want. You could even use a silly bow, presuming you just like the look of it. Anyways, I didn't go for that blizzard one yet. Whatever, we're already here. Let's drop this lightning magicite here, and this will activate the second barrier. It's okay, I already got the permanent upgrade. And we're gonna just wander off to this side over here to get at a scroll. And you'll notice that coming down here is where we started first, which is why you can come from the left side first. In the speedrun of things, I'll be taking on the lightning side first instead of the blizzard side. I just wanted to show that permanent upgrade before I forgot. So that's pretty much all there is for that. Furthermore, you can actually break the ice right here in order to use this as a checkpoint, or a quick way up, I suppose. And this is for people who, you know, activate the, or break the ice barrier first. So something to consider. It's generally faster to go lightning-wise though, since you can obviously break it from the other side. Presuming you're a Selkie. I'm not sure how you will fare if you're playing a different class or race, but yeah, there you go! Alright, let's take care of this Mew, and I think we're pretty much almost done with this area, I hope so. Kilanda is so large and expansive, it's a good thing that it doesn't span through too many maps. I'm not too fond of Kilanda though, because it does force you to clear out certain maps, or specifically one map, and that's a little annoying since that means you gotta kill like 10-15 enemies and it just slows you down. It's kind of bulky. Anyways, we got one area here and we can't really climb up here just yet, so we'll worry about the right side in a second. We can go over here and we'll notice a balloon, so let's just break that first. And this will contain us a citrine, something we don't really need, so I'll probably sell that off screen at some point. And we're gonna crawl over to the left side first instead of activating that switch, and you'll see why in a second, but we definitely want to cover our bases here first. So doesn't seem like any enemies want to spawn ya. It's a little strange, but alright. Basically, we have a key up here and we can't actually jump up here because there's an invisible wall. So you can fall down, but you can't climb up. So our goal is to get at a key. Usually there's enemies here, but apparently they don't feel like spawning just yet. So I assume that means we're gonna have to activate this switch first. So let's do that. This will lead us to a second platform, which we will also activate. And this will lead us to a balloon with a key on it. So we can break this, and now it is time for us to wander all the ways around in order to get at that key. Except I forgot. Oh, well, wait, never mind, I didn't forget. Okay, we're good. First of all, let's wander off to the left side again. Maybe the enemies will finally spawn now. Now that we've unlocked the key. Hello, anyone? This is very strange. I'm pretty sure there's supposed to be like 2 or 3 enemies here, but I guess they'll show up later. Anyways, let's hop up here and work our way through this giant corridor of enemies. Corridor is not the right word. Giant adventure way. Yeah, of enemies. You'll notice that these platforms sink below you, and this is very, very annoying for anyone who's not playing a Selkie, so move around often. Just don't stand on the ice. I would encourage you to avoid that. These ice bombs are vicious, and they have a tendency of hanging on your head for some reason, so I'm just gonna move out of the way here and get my Kira Magicite game on. There we go. Alright. Well, good thing we have double jump, so we're going to be able to move right past all these shenanigans here. Step on this platform, lowering it. And now we have two directions to go from here. One way to the key and the other way to something different. So we're going for the something different first because it doesn't advance us in the area. And that way we'll be able to clear that out first. So that's our goal after we can take care of this ice bomb. If only I could line all 3 arrows to hit you. And it looks like I can, so that's pretty good. Alright, that's one more of these stupid explosives down. Let's move on over to the right side, and you'll notice that there is a giant stone pillar erected in the middle of nowhere. Very high up, there's a barrel, there's a chest up there. You can't double jump up on it, and even standing on this barrel doesn't get you up here. It is mandatory to do magicite stacking, unless you're playing with friends. So we're gonna just stack down three magicites here, there we go. Hop on top of them, hop up here, break this chest, and that will get us another additional 2 attack boosts. So this area is evidently designed for people in either single player or multiplayer to utilize 4 players in order to get up here for those attack boosts and have those shared among people. It's a good thing that you're able to stack magicites so we don't have to do that. Now then, our next goal is to get at this barrel, and here's an interesting thing you can do. I'm gonna try to pull it off once. Doesn't seem like we're going to be able to get it on the first try though, so just keep trying here. I'll get it eventually, I just hope these magicites don't despawn. I'm willing to put the time in this. Oh, I don't understand depth of field in this area or whatever. Oh, I don't understand it at all. We'll get there. As you can tell, I'm basically trying to step on the barrel right now. You can step on the barrel, so that's pretty obvious. Alright, you know what, this is enough. Usually I prefer stepping on the barrel and then just double jumping upwards to break the balloon, but... Oh great, they're gone. Let's try this again. We'll use Ray's magicites this time since we don't really need these. Because we're a lonely, lonely person in multiplay. Did we break the balloon? Okay, we did not. Okay, so this is mandatory. Oh, first try, great. Hop up here, break the balloon, and there's nothing even that good in the barrel. Basically, we're getting a crummier refund. We lost out on one cure magicite through that, so not a fan. Let's just grab the key and move on already. Jeez. Alright, now that we've activated this checkpoint platform, we're able to hop on up here and grab the key and move on. Yeah! Okay, this did not go to the full length. I did not expect that. Right, let's move on ahead then. And now there's another low-key panel, and I presume that's another way to get at the attack boosts. I have no idea how this map works. No idea whatsoever. Anyways, we're finally at where we're supposed to be, so let's activate this key here, or lodge it somewhere else. Be careful not to fall or drop it. Please? There we go. Alright, and that will unlock our doorway. Let's break the barrel while we're at it, and what we're going to get in here is... a bunch of potions. Yes, potions. There we go. Any enemies now? None. Are you kidding me? Where did they come from? Where did they go? Hey, okay, whatever, sure. Forget it. We're gonna skip out on killing 3 enemies that may not even exist. Let's just move on ahead to our checkpoint here. There we go, and there should be a Mugo somewhere in the corner of the map, I believe, so... We can get at some money and some potions, and what do you have to say for yourself? You found me, Kupo. Allow me to give you a commemorative stamp. Kupo, right now I feel like putting my stamp here, Kupo. There we go, mission accomplished. So now that we got a fair combination of stamps, we're going to get a bunch of free materials, so... Oh, with this stamp, you've unlocked a prize. Congrats, Kupo. There we go, we got ourselves an amethyst, great, meteorite, that's endgame, ultima silk, best silk in the game, petai emerald, not too much we really need, mithril silk, always good, blue stone, eh, silk, that's fine, white dust, no, final leather, sure, dark dust, white dust, dark dust, silk, sure, I'll take it all. This is pretty much good, you don't have to worry about it, like, ruining the progress in the game, and that's primarily because you're not given any scrolls, so... You're not crafting anything ahead of yourself, and it's always nice to have a few materials hanging on by. There we go. The problem is that, if I can switch over to my materials, we're almost full of slots. Sure, we're at 54 out of 99, but we also have to account for like the other half of this whole game, and then maybe a hard and harder mode, and then our special dungeon and whatnot. Very strange. Anyways, we're at our final map before the boss, and this is the map where you need to kill every enemy. So, don't try to skim out on any of them. If you're having troubles unlocking this area, then pay close attention to this video and kill all the enemies you see. And I'll tell you some pointers to knowing whether you've killed all the enemies or not. And it's pretty basic, so not too much to worry about. I tried experimenting by killing only the plant life here and only the bombs. Doesn't matter. absolutely have to kill all the enemies here. A little bit annoying and kind of tedious, which makes me kind of hate Kilanda in a way, but on the bright side, it gets easier the further you progress, so it's not too bad. And not to mention, 4 attack boosts are pretty good. Now you've noticed I've been avoiding these things for a long time. By hopping into them, they launch you like crazy. These things will send you flying, so let's see if I can angle myself. Okay, well, I'm being launched constantly to the end of the stream, but these things will send you flying across the map. It's like the physics engine bugs out. Look at that. Not to mention, you can actually send enemies over here by like pushing them or something. I'm tempted to do that to this stupid ice bomb here, but I can't carry it. Here, let's lure this guy. We got some time to kill. It's been 30 minutes. Here, we're gonna... Hey, take it easy there, buddy. We're gonna push you there. Come on, hang over here. This guy's not having it. He's not a fan of fire. Well, that's fine. Oh, wait. Yeah, come on. Get over here, you little blue fart. Get over here. Come on. Yeah. Oh, ha! Got him. Yeah, send him knocking away. Yeah, come on. Get over here, you little fool. You afraid? Oh, okay. Whoa, that sends you flying. It really does. Okay, well, you know, enough of that nonsense. We sent him flying before. I think it knows. It's learned its lesson. Don't mess with Raylazor. Take care of this guy. Yeah, go get him, Silkia. Alright. So far, so good. Anything else going on over here? Another ice bomb and I believe a fire bomb right beside him. Yep, alright. Well, you know what to do here, folks. Let's just not get too close to them. Yeah, eat it. Okay, let's try to get you too. Might as well, since we're already locked into a tribe ability, so we might as well make good use of them. There we go. Alright. Not much to worry about. Now over here, there's no platform to spawn. You literally just walk through it or just jump across. And if you notice that this plant spawns, that means you've killed all the enemies, so you're able to advance on this bottom floor. If you don't see this plant spawn, it means you missed someone, so something to keep in mind. Anyways, let's stand on this platform here and move on ahead. If you hop off that switch, it will actually start lowering, so stay on target. Cool. What else do we have here? A scroll containing a dragonish helm. Okay. So that's different from a dragoon helm. And we'll be able to see all those differences later. It's not too big of a difference. I believe that's going to be the armor set we're going for after this dungeon. So we'll be able to see that in action soon. But not right now. Mainly because we're busy being lit on fire while trying to hit enemies. Yeah. If I have the status ailment, does it mean that I won't be affected by too many other status ailments? I hope that's the case. You know what, this is a waste of time. Let's get up close here. Take care of you. Yeah, there we go. I assume people with a high frost resistance find this whole area easy, except for the fire stuff that's going on. I am not in a good spot right now. Let's just back up here. There we are. Okay, well, as long as we don't get blown up. Heal ourselves right now, just in case. Prevent ourselves from any potential future dangers. But so far, so good. Another one of those stupid fire things. Those things are so annoying when you're trying to run ahead because they have intensity of knocking you down like that. Great, let's just get on over here. That would be humiliating if I got hit by the second one too. All right, wandering our way back up. Because there's no invisible wall, because there are invisible walls, we can't just double jump up here. We can't glitch the system. And even if we did, it means we can't get at the boss, so. Gotta really time our jumps apparently with these stupid things hanging around. There he goes, heavenly specs. Not too much to worry about there. Cool, let's run around in circles and take care of this plant. Cool, I think that's all of them. Yes it is, and this will spawn our second set of things. And that guy will only spawn if you kill the first set of enemies. So, mandatory killing, it's no fun. Let's take care of our third floor now and we'll hopefully get our ways to the fourth floor within the same lifetime. There we go. And not too much to worry about. We'll stand in the fire since we don't have to worry too much about that. Cool. Just cast your spell there, buddy. Sure, I'll take that. And down. Great. Alright, what else do we have to deal with here? Anything here? An ice bomb? Here, you should hop down here, buddy. Apparently, you're not affected by fire either, which is kind of intimidating. Just gonna hang back over here then. It's a good thing we have a good resistance level on this, so we don't have to worry too much about just hopping around everywhere trying not to get hit. Always a good time. Alright, let's break this target. There we go. Hop on this platform and move on to the fourth and final floor, which contains only three enemies, so we can do this. This might also be the proving grounds for us to use our piercing shot, or what is it, straight arrow? Is that what they call it? It's not really. As you can tell, not very helpful. It's always good to do a little bit of extra damage on others though. Helps speed up the process all in all, but not by very much. And I think I'm just gonna run around in circles first, avoid your spell, and take you out. There we go. And by doing so, that will spawn ourselves a switch, a platform, and a sign. Okay, let's grab this courageous weapon scroll, which is obviously what we're going to craft in the future. Step on this platform. Halfway through, somewhat. Talk to it. Bad vibes beyond this point, Kupo. Brace yourselves. And this is, as you can tell, where we're going to fight this boss. And this is annoying. You know, I'm just going to double jump. But yes, you can just single jump over. It might get a little bit annoying, but these platforms will move back. So, don't worry. Great, so this boss fight has two sections right now. First, we gotta deal with the prison guard, and then the dragon that's the fat, stinky lizard that's that he's sitting on. So what you want to do is generally hit him in the necklace, and this will knock him off. You can also jump on top of the mount in order to control it and fire shots of rage and anger at this guy. So where is he? We'll teach you a lesson. Over time, he will attempt to get back on it, and generally he will succeed, so that's not too much to worry about. What I prefer to do is actually jump off and simply fire arrows at him, simply because, as you can tell, it does a lot more damage and it keeps him from getting on the dragon. Usually, there we go. Yeah, get off. You know what? We're gonna end you with a humiliating attack. How does that feel? And this will lead us to our second portion of the boss fight, or the real boss fight, dealing with this rampaging lizard who's trying to just stomp on us. So the problem with this guy is that he's pretty hard to kill, and there's no easy way of taking care of him. What you have to do, from what I understand, is shoot his tail until he gets fatigued. So you're able to drain stamina by hitting it in the tail occasionally. I don't know. What you're trying to do is basically tire it out, and that way you'll be able to get easy pickings on its tail. I find it generally the easiest to fire arrows at its tail because of the extra damage, and potentially it'll increase the stamina drainage you do. But otherwise, there's no real means. You'll notice you can't actually mount on the guy because there's a giant fire thing on it, which does a lot of damage. This lizard is also able to spit out like a fireball or an ice ball or something, which pretty much one hit kills any selkie in its pathway, so you gotta be really careful about that. We're gonna just try our best to fatigue this thing, and that way we'll be able to kill this guy. So it starts off really slow, and there we go, it's fatigued. We can jump on its tail and immediately start stomping on it, and usually this will lead it to waking up, knocking you off, and then falling back to sleep. So there we go. You also have to be a little bit cautious because there are certain points on the tail and back that will cause you to get knocked off due to spike damage. I don't know what points they are. It seems like the part of the tail that's not spiky will lead to this, but it's generally just a very confusing hitbox. So try to step on the tail where you can, despite the fact that it's all pointy looking, and that will do you just fine. So let's get a few more hits on you. There we go. Drained its stamina there, and let's keep on going, and it looks like we're going to have a relatively easy boss fight. And with that, we should finish you off, hopefully. Take care of you. Oh, okay. That got stressful there. I thought I was gonna game over. Alright. There we go. Alright, what do we have here? We got a victorious weapon, buccaneer suit, executioner's mask, a ton of other garbage. Cool. I'm just gonna pick all this up. Now, we still have quite a few healing item, so I think we're just gonna go in and do our speedrun of Kilanda IO right away. So let's go. Basically, you wanna run straight through this area, and obviously since the door is unlocked, you don't have to kill any of these bees or take care of any of the barrels. Great first round, always good. We're not done yet here, folks, because we can just run straight off to the right side and go straight for that Loti platform we saw earlier. If we're fast enough, we can double jump onto this, move right up on here, and start the platform away for the second coming. Yeah, for the second location. And with this, we're able to launch a key straight off into the slot. Unfortunately, it takes a little bit of time for the door to open up, so you can often get hit because of it. And afterwards, we can just drop straight down here because, once again, this door is already open, so you don't have to go through the whole area in order to get at all the items and monsters. Moving on here, we can hop straight across these things because we don't have to worry about it. You can actually do it so fast that if I can pull this off well, you can usually grab the key while it's already in the cutscene. That's just more of a bragging rights thing since it doesn't really affect any speed. I suppose you have it right away, but you can grab it in the cutscene if you're fast enough. Moving on ahead, here we got a red platform, yellow platform, fire, blizzard, lightning, magicites, and whatnot. I usually go for the fire one first, wait for the barrier to break, and what I'll do is double jump right up here. If you're fast enough, you can actually avoid the cutscene altogether and get to the lightning platform beforehand. Go for the second one right here, and this will activate the second one. There we go. And then, of course, we're going to break these ice barriers and just hop and move straight towards that blizzard platform. So, we're pretty much good to go. Platform, table, pillar, I don't know. There we go. That should work. And the third barrier is broken. That worried me for a second there. I was a little bit worried that it just fell straight off. So, it looks like we're good though. So, we can hop right here. And off to the second platform. Now you're going to assume that it's pretty hard to get up here, and I'm going to take a little bit of time, but as you figured, you can actually just double jump right across and grab the key right away. What most people don't realize is that you can't double jump up here unless you step on the key, which provides the perfect footstool to getting up onto this platform, and that will let us get straight up ahead and move on. Anyways, we are going to throw this right on our heads against the wall, and this will allow us to just carry it, double jump across, and move straight towards the keyhole. Yeah, there we go. And that will let us move right on ahead. So, a lot faster than you may expect. You absolutely must jump on top of the key to use it as a footstool. And that way, we will be able to move straight to the checkpoint, and I believe this takes us to the final map where we have to kill everything. So, this is where things slow down because there's no easy way of doing this. As long as you have the high amount of attack power, you should be just fine. So let's just take care of these guys, and it generally shouldn't be too much of a problem. Yeah, take care of them. Eat it. These bombs are a little annoying, and usually you can just avoid them after you get them flashing. Which denotes that they're about to blow up, by the way, if you haven't realized yet. So that should do it. There we go. I'm just gonna move on ahead now and deal with these other guys as well. Alright, come on. That should be one. Yeah, there we go. Run in circles. Deal with the second guy. Oh, no! Okay, we're good. Oh, jeez, we don't have healing magicites on. Christ. Oh, hey, you spawn regardless. Okay, never mind. I guess you aren't a key teller on whether things are done or not. I guess I'm just too good at completing things in order. Alright, whatever. Let's take care of this plant while we still can then. And there we go. Step right around here and this should let us stand right on top of the platform. There we go. And advance straight on ahead. So far so good. Not too much to worry about. You can try to angle your shots so the straight arrow will benefit you at long range, but I don't really care much about that. I'm gonna pick up this material while we're at a petite ruby. Always nice. I would love to grab the extra materials that are lying around, but that kind of slows us down. If they're nearby on the pathway, I'll grab them just for the sake of crafting in the future, since it's always good to have a few extra scrolls here and there. And now I gotta deal with this stupid guy here, slowing us down once more. Get a nice meat shot on him. There we go, cool, see you later. Done with you. Oh, gonna get knocked there, alright. Hop straight across, deal with you as well, Mr. Plant Man. There we are, alright. Something over here, great. I'm just gonna jump on the staff and double jump up here. Take care of you as well. Come on, there we go. Charge up my attack while we're at it. And hopefully kill this guy quickly. He's flashing already, so I'm just gonna go for the heal while I still can. He's doing a surprising amount of damage. I didn't expect it to do that much damage. Usually bombs are relatively weak. I might just be really low on defense or something, so whatever. Let's move on ahead here. Charge up and attack. And key. Oh, I missed. Darn. Oh well. Maybe next time. But that is a way of speeding things up if you can. Let's hop up on here and deal with our final three plant monsters of the day. And then we can go straight for the behemoth. Or whatever the thing you call it. Prison guard. Right. Prison guard and fat lizard. Fat stinky lizard dragon. Whatever you want to call that darn thing. I believe you can just double jump from this end as well. So we're going to try it right now. This might end poorly though. And it looks like it's going to end poorly. Okay. Well. Whatever. On the bright side, I believe we can actually double jump from here without touching the switch, so this is a good way of clearing out some time. And straight to the boss, right on. Don't care too much about your spell there, mister. Oh, got him down? Great. Alright, let's chase this guy down. And it speaks English, as you can tell. So I'm just gonna stop and be quiet real quick. So as you can tell, it says go away and oh, that hurt. Very strange, since you rarely hear things speak English except in the story mode cutscenes. But hey, whatever, I'll take it. Anyways, now comes the point where our run through will probably be extremely slow, and that's us trying to fatigue the stupid monster. So let's see how this goes. Hopefully we're able to fatigue it relatively quickly. It doesn't seem like it. No, not doing too bad. I wish it would just lay down already though. Oh. And it does a lot of damage, by the way, so you're always in constant danger. Make sure you keep your health up during this boss fight, if I haven't mentioned that well enough yet. We're doing some solid damage, so it should be going into a fatigue mode soon. There we are. There we go. Step on this lovely tail and get right on cracking. So as you can tell, we do a lot more damage this way. Are you gonna lay down? Yes, you are. Great. Excuse me, we're just gonna hop right on. I'm a little bit dangerous, and I'm a little bit low on health right now, but generally we shouldn't have to worry too much about it. Cool. It laid back down so we can go in for another third strike, and we're doing a lot of damage here, so I guess this boss fight will be relatively quick, except the fact that it just stopped. Anyways, that should do it. There we go, get down. Yeah, how does it feel having no stamina, you lazy, fat, stupid lizard? Eat it! Oh, no! Eat it! Yeah! Alright, there you go. And we got a level up out of it, too. Fantastic. Let's grab this stuff here and move on over to Rebena Te Ra. Anti-fire armor, there we go. More confusing things to deal with. Just go at it from around just to make sure we don't accidentally pick up anything we don't want. There we are. Or accidentally run in through the portal. There we go, let's head on over to Rebena Te Ra, and there's plenty to talk about here. So, first up, welcome to Rebena Te Ra. Now that nearly everyone's back in town, I'll finally have a chance to prove my worth as a town guide. Great, that's good. You don't say anything different, I believe, so we're just gonna avoid you, puppy. Over here, practically everybody is back in town, now's our chance. Yes, we can slip in among the mashes and shyly sneak out of sight. Good plan. Too bad I'm in on it. Alright, well these guys are just doing something there. I can never nail that voice. We've got a guard over here. Maybe we'll do a silly voice here. Looks like the pace of things is picking up around here. Even though the town has evolved bit by bit over the years, I'm still stuck in the same old boring job. What have I done with my life? Has it all been one huge mistake? What if my existence doesn't matter? Maybe I'm just an NPC. Ah, who cares? If the world rejects me, scrub it. I'll make my own world, where I'm a king. Ah, Old Town is up ahead. Monsters appear without warning, so please proceed with utmost caution. I take my job duties seriously. Doing my part in the world gives me a sense of purpose in life, which is why I'm going to become the Hierophant. Ah, the distant sound of... The sound of distant throng is a lullaby to my aching ears. Alright, well you take care of that, buddy. What else do you have to say here? I heard the folks who bolted town before are flooding back in. I didn't notice they were gone. that's so me. Having everyone back in town is all good, well and good, but come on. It's the same old faces on parade. Just once I'd like to see a drop-dead gorgeous hunk stop by this podunk town. Well, you keep on dreaming. Maybe one day. Alright, anything in the village square? I believe there should be a fellow right here. There we are. Hi there, are you a visitor? Welcome to Rebena Te Ra. I hope you enjoy your stay. Heh, I actually just got back from vacation myself. The town seems emptier than before. Where is everybody? Have they all gone on vacation? My vacation was great. It was live like a sinner for 8 days and 7 nights on Kilanda, Io tour. My friend got lost during the tour though. I wonder if she's back yet. Ah, she'll be alright. She's not back yet! Where could she possibly be? Dude, it's been like 10 seconds. There was some issues there, you need help? Oh, great, thanks. Thanks a lot, Adobe Acrobat Reader DC. I would get rid of you, but I sort of need to read PDF files. Anyways. People are pretty much settled in. Life here is worth coming back to. Thanks to the large crystal here in Rebena Te Ra, we always have pure air and clean water. Alright. As well, the townsfolk and the shopkeepers will also say new things too. Welcome to the Magic Goods. We have Magisite for magic and items for your healing needs. Oh, is it you? You're the adventurer who's been working so hard for Rebena Te Ra. Thanks to you, the town's coming back to life and sales are booming again. We're all very grateful for what you've done so far and hope you'll continue your charitable work. Now that I've said my piece, welcome! We have a full stock of Magisites and healing items. Well, you know what? Screw your capitalism! Oh, maybe I don't want anything! How's that feel? Maybe you should start selling the apples and stuff you have on display instead of magic. Maybe I want to eat food for once. Jeez! Anyways, we got this guy here who I don't know what to do a voice for, so we're just gonna go for like Toad and then a little bit of satanic stuff on the side. That's probably what this guy is like.
Hello and welcome. You're looking in fine form today, valued customer. What do you make of these recent events here? We are in the midst of what can only be called a renaissance. From what I hear, an extremely heroic adventurer is working day and night to fuel this revival. Most impressive, I must say, to dedicate one's body and soul. Why, if I could turn back time. terribly sorry. An old habit of mine I can't seem to shake. Let's settle these trivial matters aside for a moment, shall we? Welcome to Chappie's Workshop, where our motto is relax and leave the customizing to us.
Alright, well, let's see what we got crafting here. Oh, actually, let's buy stuff first. What materials do we have here for sale? We got stuff I don't want. Lovely. Mithril, hey, this stuff is here. That's what we needed, so let's buy a bunch of that stuff. Mithril shard, gold, we'll worry about that in a second here. Moofer, we have 24. Actually, we won't be needing that stuff. How about scrolls? Do we have anything here that we may want? Maybe stuff from like today's fight? No? Samurai helmet? Did we even do this before? Oh, we can't craft these. Never mind. Yeah, this stuff looks like it's pretty old, so I don't think we'll be needing any of it. Band of abilities, that's actually what I want, but it's unfortunately out of sale and we don't have any in stock. Maybe in the future. Scrolls that we won't worry about for now, and absolutely nothing. Great, let's get to crafting then. So our first thing on the chopping block is going to be our weapon, which is obviously our victorious weapon, I believe. So let's pick this guy out, and hopefully we have a ruby. We have an amethyst. Alright, let's give it a go. We're going to get a hero's bow with tribal secrets 3, which is everything I want, attack boost 3, which is even better, and an impact boost just to kick things off. So we got pretty much the best bow that I'll ever want for a long time. I might even keep this around for like the next set of bows, so I don't know. This is a pretty solid weapon, and you can obviously improve your magic a little bit as well with the angel's weapon instead, which we can craft in a second. We just need to make some seraph dust. We'll worry about that later. Dragonish helmet, I believe this will create us the Dragon salad, yes. So we're going to make this right away because we need one of these. And let's go with a... You know what? Let's go with a petite ruby. Let's go for some attack power. I'm gonna get a dragon salad and attack boost. Great. That's everything I wanted. So let's equip that. Oh yeah, nice gold there. And let's go for our uniform real quick. Where is it? Do we not have one? Oh no. What? Could it be? Oh, we don't have the second piece of the set. How annoying. Great. Well, it looks like we're gonna have to pick something else then, so... Jeez, maybe one of these two things then. Anti-fire armor and anti-ice armor. Can I make either of these hats? Okay, well, I can make one of these two hats, so... Jeez. Okay, well, that's kind of rough. We're gonna have to go off-screen for that stuff. Right then. Let's just worry about that stuff later, and... Do I want fire or ice? I think I'll go for fire then. Right, let's just make an anti-heat helmet then. Why not? I prefer wearing sets, so that will be the case. What are we gonna get from the flame salad? Attack boost, alright, fair enough. We got an improving attack, so that's not too bad whatsoever. Cool, we'll wear the flame salad. And where's that anti-fire armor? There we go. This is what we want, right? Fire harness? Flame harness, great. Okay, let's make one of these two. Alright, and we'll put an amethyst on you too. Oh wait, didn't I make a petite ruby before? Do we have one of those still? We do not. Okay. Amethyst it is then. What are we gonna get from this then? Fire harness with body boost? I don't know what that is for, but sure. We'll equip that. There we are. Ooh, okay, that's interesting. And I think we only have one flan goop. Do we need flan goop for the other hat as well? Jeez, it looks like I'm gonna have to get and go out there and buy flan goop as well. Alright, well, we'll make an anti-code helmet. And we'll equip this in the future, but not today. So this will probably be shown off-screen, like, at the end of the video, because, one, I'm missing a piece of the dragon set armor, and apparently I'm going to be missing a piece of the, ice? Yeah, the ice harness armor, so... We're gonna have to worry about that later. The robber's rag cannot be crafted. It's only for male clavats, I believe. Yes, all males of all tribes. Here's the thing, it's a bandit bandana. However, let's see here. Do I not have that either? What? I'm missing so many pieces of equipment. Oh, darn. Well, anyways, you can also get a piece of bandit armor. And for some reason, females of all races can wear that, but not the bandana. And we have the buccaneer suit here, which is the pirate outfit, which is for selkies only. I would definitely want to wear this, but we're going to have to keep this for the future. It doesn't seem like we have a pirate hat, though. We have a skeletal mask. I'll make this for, like, off-screen. This is kind of strange, so we're not going to be equipping this today. It's kind of terrifying. And of course the princess's insignia, which we'll also wear in the future, the princess's tiara. So that will be off screen as well. Thunderous garb, I think this is like an old item. Yes it is, yellow outfit, silver armor, we've done that before. Great, so we have a few things to worry about there. What's a lucidity emblem? Blackout badge, okay, we don't need one of those. And I guess that's it. It's a very, very strange how we're missing like 2-3 pieces of armor. Ugh.
I vow to do all I can to see this town gets everything it deserves. I hope you'll help.
Alright, well, you take care, buddy. Gonna craft things for us? Yeah.
Hello, good to see you. The town is beginning to look like its old self again, huh? The noise and clatter of people coming and going through town is music to my ears. Loud, but good. While you're here, take your time and check out our whole inventory.
Alright, do you have anything that we're missing then? Because I would love it if you did.
Dragon salad! Oh, good. Okay, cool.
We can get the dragon armor then, right?
Yes, dragon harness. Oh,
saved me today. Thank you, armor. Thank you. I know I don't usually buy your stuff because I don't want it, but... Alright, well, we're going to stick with the flame harness then because we already have a full set of that stuff with the gemstones equipped. I'll show the dragon harness set off screen, but I've never ran it with the flame stuff, so... It seems like we get an increased attack power, that's pretty good. Gonna look different though.
We appreciate your business.
Alright, well I appreciate your business for getting me a dragon salad. Usually I equip that stuff instead, but this flame salad is looking... this flame set looks pretty darn good too, so let's take a look. Yeah, it's basically the iron armory skin to be looking red. Ugh, I said that weird. It's basically the iron armor set reskinned red, but I think it suits it. The red and gold decor, it's not too bad whatsoever. Of course, it's a reskin, so that's kind of gross, but hey, I will take it. So there we are. Got a bunch of attack power now. We're gonna be ruining enemies in the next video. This guy doesn't say anything new because it's not the temple. We haven't unlocked the temple yet. I think there's supposed to be a guy up here. There we are. Whoa! What's going on? When did all these people show up? I know I'm a simple kind of guy, but I should have noticed that. Maybe I'm not cut out for this line of work. Oh, hello adventurer. Your endeavors are gaining you quite a reputation around here. But you needn't worry about the townspeople. We are prepared to defend them what come may. Defend them come what may. Oh, ugh. Buddy, read a dictionary. Actually, I should probably be the one too. Anyways, Mogmar, our final shopkeeper of the day. Say, seems to me there are more folks in town than there were before. Now that I think about it, a whole slew of people came rushing in right around the time I got back. I'm not surprised. I can't blame them for wanting to inspect the latest haul of my arduous trip. I supplied troops of customers with items unbelievable. I am the very model of a modern Mughal general. And on that note, welcome to Mogmart. If you have the money, we have the merchandise. Ah yes, HP boost. We are definitely going to need some of those. And an SP boost, always lovely. A quick note is that I won't be overloaded once I do the grinding of Kilanda off-screen for the scrolls, because I actually just reset that stuff after I film everything. So, don't worry, I'm not up ahead in levels, as you can tell. It just gets reset afterwards, so I can show off the uniforms and outfits without having to worry about that stuff. Anyways, let's worry about these pockets, shall we? A raised pocket, not exactly what we need, but I'll take two clear pockets because we haven't gotten any ether buffs yet. Hey, we got one ether pouch, great. And two potion pouches is always love. I'm hoping for a few more cure pouches in the future, but that's good. I'll fight to bring you the best. Bing bam, pow kerblooey. Business is booming at Mogmart. Alright, you do your thing there, buddy. Alright, well, now's our time to do what we must, and that's go do a quest. Let's go, yeah. Talk to these two guards here. I guess nearly everybody's back in town for now. Now, for a while there, I was wondering what was going on. Our army is downright pathetic. The other day, the subjugation squad came back all beat up. Not one to suffer defeat gladly, King Koka patched them up and sent them back out with a pep talk. They're probably out there right now, picking Mughal plants or clinging to alien abducted cows. Those of us in the Royal Army of Rebena Te Ra could learn a thing or two from you adventurer types. We can practice all we want, but until we get real experience, we won't know how we'll do in battle. Alright, and how about you? The town's pretty much made a full recovery, but they're still recruiting for quests. King Koka, as always, likes to take things slow and easy. Why change what's working, eh? He probably figures the town has made his made a comeback because of those plant. Oh! He probably figures the town has made a comeback because of those quests he planned. But it saps adventurers like you who did the real work of getting rid of all the monsters. King Koka may appear harsh on the outside, but he's a ruler with a heart of gold. I wouldn't be surprised if most of the townsfolk came back out of pure respect and admiration for him. And if we deal with the advisor here, mind your manners, you are in the presence of His Majesty. You'll notice that she doesn't notice you anymore, and that's because the town is pretty darn busy, so we are just fading in there now, without any recognition except from townspeople, and, well, primarily shopkeepers who are basically trying to sell us the stuff. We don't even get a discount, it's terrible. Anyways, hello King Koka. I've been waiting for you, brave adventurer. Have you seen what's happening in town? The atmosphere grows more wildly festive by the hour. Obviously an outpouring in tribute of my kingly virtues. Ah, but let's turn our attention to the matters at hand. I assume you have come for a quest. No, I have come to ruin your day. Oh, I see. Came all this way just to change your mind. I appreciate you going to all that trouble, I do. Can it be that you've had a change of heart? Thought you'd do us a big favor and go on a quest for us?
No.
It figures. Alright, well enough taunting Coca. What quests do we have to do here? It looks like we only have tough cookies as a unique thing to do from now on, so... we're gonna do tough cookies. It's basically, eliminate all monsters. Each batch of foes defeated extends the time limit. So, let's do that. Now, you're supposed to actually do this as your very first quest, which is something I clearly didn't do. Kind of strange, isn't it? But whatever, let's accept the quest and get to it. Conquest is in a fleeting affair, for no enemy can truly be... For no enemy can ever truly be annihilated. The moment you think you have a land under control, the enemy can return in the blink of an eye. Nevertheless, the inevitability finds a certain romance in searching and destroying the enemy. From mountaintops to valleys, through forests and beyond, to frontiers yet unseen, exterminate the rampaging beast, slay them all and reclaim our lands. Justice is on our side. As good as that felt to say, you may find this quest endless. But hang in there. But you must hang in there and never give up. Perseverance shall lead to strength. Yeah. Oh, I am butchering so many lines. It's a good thing that we're at the end of like the video, kind of. That's good. At least I got through like most of the townspeople. Anyways, these guys are pretty mushy since they're like level 4 people. You could even consider it pointless to grab the stuff they drop, but I'll probably go for the materials since those are always necessary. But yeah. An interesting thing with tough cookies is going to be able to be seen after we complete our kills of 20 here. But otherwise, this will be a relatively easy laid-back quest. I don't have much to say. Right after this, I'll probably be working on editing this, getting it out as fast as possible, and then working immediately to record the next video since I don't want to be 2 weeks behind for everything. So yeah, that's going to be what's happening here. Hopefully I'll be able to record other things on the side as well, but after this I'll probably immediately get to working on the equipment sets, the costume sets, so we can get that done as well. And during that time I will probably also craft the bandit's bandana, even though we can't equip it, just for the sake of simplicity here. Or something. Ugh, I don't know. I don't know my words anymore. I have lost all ability to speak English. Ah, alright, woe is me. Let's just take care of these guys and call it a day. We'll actually head to the Mugmar afterwards, though, to get some extra upgrades. But nonetheless, on the bright side, I'll be able to use all of this fantastic equipment and a nice, amazing, hardcore, high attack, sexy red iron armor costume. And just completely destroy everyone in Kilanda. Just, you know, mash all their faces in. And then I'll be able to get all the costume sets. Hopefully I'll be able to get them all in like one try or something. Because there's like, oh, 3 or 4 items that we need to collect. And then I, of course, need to get the materials to, you know, craft the stuff like the flan goop. Definitely ran out of that stuff. Grab this thing for haste, run away fast, cool. Anyways, at the end of every stage, you will be able to get a chest. And inside will contain a bunch of gil and magicites. Now here's the thing, you get a lot of money and it scales pretty well with you. I remember playing on my DS and getting up to like 4,000 gil per piece. So I would get 8,000 gil for completing each level, which is pretty amazing. So if you're in the realm for money, it is extremely viable to just go for elimination missions, because you get a ton of money. You're getting some EXP to level yourself back up on pace, and you're getting materials if you're running low on them. So these quests are fantastic, and what I will probably do from now on is actually work on these elimination quests with breaking through with the other quests if I ever get bored. Simply because I would love to have some extra materials on hand, always great. And of course, I want to hang out at the castle every time in order to obtain the low lines of dialogue from King Coca and whatnot. There we go. So far so good though, not too much to worry about. However, since this is the last stage, we won't actually be able to get one of those chests that contains a ton of gil and magicites. So, this happens for pretty much every stage except the last one. Anyways, so far so good. How does it feel to get completely stomped on monsters? Yeah, this is how I felt at the start of the game. being a stupid Selkie with like no attack power whatsoever, having to stomp on everyone. No, my bow is what you will fear. Selkies are the best. Double jumping is the best. You need to get off my stupid head. My head is not stupid. Selkia's head is not stupid. You're stupid. There we go. Alright, so far so good. Not too much to say. I believe we're doing Raylazor. We're doing Shadowland Past. No, Shadowlands in general next, so that will be a fine video to do. Fine, fun. I think I said both of those words at the same time. I'm pretty much stalling for time right now because there's not too much to say about this quest. They're relatively easy and I believe the quests are pretty hard to ever get done. So it'll go by Tough Cookies and I believe it'll lead to like Tough Cookies 99 and then it'll move on to Rough Cookies. And then it's like, it never stops. It's like Tough Cookies, Rough Cookies, Stale Cookies or something. There's a good like at least 500 elimination missions or something. I have never completed the whole chain just because there's too many of them. So maybe there is something at the end of the tunnel? Who knows? That's it. Quest completed. The new quest, Tough Cookies 2, is now available. Now you'll notice that earlier on you saw how like Tough Cookies 4 and 7 and whatnot were already available. It'll scale for you automatically, but you will need to complete 1 to unlock 2 and whatnot, even though you unlocked 4. Stuff like that. I am glad to see you are back alive. Your skills were most impressive. Thanks to your bravery, our country is slowly but surely regaining its peace as before. So he's telling us the dialogue that we heard during our first quest, and that's because Tough Cookies is supposed to be our first quest, as you can see. Extermination missions may seem endless, but you must remember that the end will come someday. So maybe there's an end? Maybe. Please accept a small token of our appreciation. By the way, we could not decide on how to distribute our gifts, so you shall race for what you can grab within an allotted time. Whether you want to approach this in a cooperative or cutthroat way is entirely up to you. Also, I apparently have amnesia. Go! And of course, we're going to be getting a ton of garbage prizes. Bluestone, Fey Dust, hand-me-downs? Rugged clothes? Oak branch? Ugh, stop. And good day, till we meet again. So there you go. Maybe the prizes get better if you're doing harder missions, but that's something we'll be able to figure out in the future since we've done all the unique missions. But I think that's about it. Let's go to the Mogmart and buy ourselves an extra HP boost. There we go. Gotta correct myself. Always important. Stay on top of grammar, kids, because it's important. There we are. Lots of pockets, so that's great. And a Thunder Pocket to boot, and we pretty much need those since we were sitting at 18. That's all there is. And I don't know if that's new dialogue or not, but I'm not gonna say it. There we go. Is that all there is around here? I'm gonna check the bottom of the town square. Octagon? Octagon, just to make sure that there's no guard here. So yeah, the guard down here has moved up to the top where the roof was. And that's it for this episode of Ring of Fates. Thank you for watching, and in the next one, we're heading off to Shadowland. See you then.